HCAM News is supported by our viewers and by Hopkinton Drug, located in this historic New England town since 1954. They are a multifaceted store dedicated to providing clients with an array of healthcare options.
And by Webster First Federal Credit Union, providing financial products with attentive customer service to the local families and businesses of Hopkinton. Visit us at WebsterFirst.com.
Hello and welcome to HCAM News. Matt Cardillo at the Anchor Desk to fill you in what's happening in Hopkinton. On this edition of HCAM News, we have the latest in Hiller Sports. Elmwood Elementary hosted Intern Night, and we have the results of this year's Hopkinton Town Election. But first, here are some happenings in the town you should know about.
The Sharon Timlin Memorial 5K and Family Fun Day will take place at Hopkinton Middle School on Saturday, June 15th. Race to benefit the Angel Fund and cure ALS. For more information or to sign up, head over to SharonTimlinRace.org. The 5th Annual Senior Center Art Show will be on display May 21st through May 28th. Head down to the Hopkinton Senior Center to check out some work from knitters, painters, quilters, and potters. On May 27th, don't miss the Memorial Day services in Hopkinton. You can find all the details and locations of the festivities at our website, hcam.tv.
This past Monday, the annual Hopkinton Town Election took place. Mike Tarosian and Tom Nappy were on the scene to bring you the results.
It's for Selectman Brennan Tedstone, 1,097. These are total votes, by the way. Claire Wright, 932. Mary Jo Lafreniere, 990. And Shadul Manon, 931. So getting the Selectman seats is Brennan Tedstone and Mary Jo Lafreniere. And then for Town Moderator, Thomas Garabedian will continue to be the town moderator with 1,064 votes.
That's
and then you have Ellen Rutter with 1,004. And then for the three-year seat for Parks and Rec, Cynthia Esheimer beats out Peter Edwards and Robert Davis. Cynthia had 869 votes, and Peter had 579, Robert with 520. And for Commissioners of Trust Funds, it's Susan Kuras with 1,272, Gerald Tewitt with 654, and then for the Planning Board two-year seat, it was Robert Benson with 975 and Michael McNamara with 674. So it's Robert Benson getting the Planning Board seat, Susan Kuras getting the Commissioner of Trust Fund seat, Cynthia Esheimer getting the Parks and Recreation seat, Thomas Garabedian remains Town Moderator, and the Selectmen, Brandon Tedstone and Mary Jo Lafreniere. And speaking of Brennan Tedstone, we have him right here. Brennan, how's it going?
Hey, Tom, how are you?
Oh, look, we got Mike, too.
Come on in, guys.
So how you feeling right now?
Obviously, I feel good. You know, anytime you're in any type of race or contest, anytime you've got a score to keep, you always want to win. So, but, you know, that's a personal thing, you know, professionally for the town. I said in all my debates, I would implore people that if they didn't think that I was the best person to be a selectman in town, it doesn't bolster my resume as a nurse. I want what's best for the town. So win or lose.
So this year was your second race.
It was.
How'd it feel compared to the first one? Any big differences other than changing your name from selectman to select
the select board? I changed it all and. It was, so the last month was, quite frankly, it was a horrible month.
Yeah.
There was a lot of extraneous stuff that went on outside of what I thought was for the best of the town, stuff that that I don't think had anything to do with local politics that was brought into play, which I didn't like. But It is what it is. We weathered the storm, and so three more years. Hashtag.
3 more years. Wow. We'll see what happens in 2.5, what he does. See if those signs pop up again.
They will not.
How was it out there today? I know some rain came by.
The rain was awesome.
It rained out today? I didn't know that.
The rain was absolutely awesome. I went through 6 of my 7 dozen shirts that I have personally, and but no, it was a long day. I think I got up here at 06, and it's now 8:30. I'm heading down to a pizza place in the center of town to have a couple of slices of pizza only, maybe a fresca.
Maybe a fresca. Gotta love that fresca.
That's it.
Well, congratulations, Brendan, and I guess we'll see you next Tuesday.
Next Tuesday. But I would like to kind of recant my on the debate. I was a little off. I'd like to change my snap answer to say, yes, I do think that the Bruins will win the Stanley Cup.
All right. Awesome.
You should. Did it take a sweep to convince you?
It didn't matter what it takes. I don't know much about hockey. I'm new at this game.
Yeah. I know. You're usually a tennis guy.
Yeah. Tennis and darts. Big into darts. So thanks to everyone. Thanks to HCAM.
Congratulations.
For all the stuff you guys did. Thank you, guys.
All right. We'll see you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
Thanks, I appreciate it.
All right, well, there you have it, Brendan Ted Stone.
Yeah, he's a little happy.
On the select board.
I think he's a little happy.
Though. I think so.
But
it was some very tight races.
How'd those
year.
Questions do?
The questions all passed. I didn't get the total amount.
Yeah, but
they're
all big numbers, right. So that means we're getting a new ladder truck. Hopkins getting some municipal parking, much-needed municipal parking at Town Hall.
Absolutely. I mean,
people don't understand that Town Hall only has 8 parking spaces.
Right.
The rest belong to the Lodge and Bill's Pizza, so... And they've been so gracious over the years, letting the residents use that for town business.
Yep.
And that's outstanding. So we're getting that in the underwrite.
Yep. So all of it passed. The questions passed without a doubt. But the some of the races this year are just so tight. It's unbelievable. I mean, when you look at these numbers, when you look at town moderator, Tom Garabedian only beating Ellen Rutter by 65 votes.
65 votes, you know. And you know what? When you're at these kind of elections, too, you can't go wrong.
Right.
And these are all people that are stepping up, volunteering. You know, yes, it is a partisan election, but you know what? Everyone's a neighbor.
Oh, absolutely.
And you can't lose. You know, you got somebody. And all this is the face that you see up there.
Yep. And, you know, all these people put a lot of work in to their campaigns, and they really care about the town. So,
yeah,
I mean,
sure do.
I don't think there was a bad candidate on the
No, not a single one. You know, when you have the competitiveness, you know you got people wanting to serve the town. And
right.
It's about that they don't get a single dime. If anything, it costs them money. It costs them time away from their families and so forth.
A lot of time.
So it is great to see this process go. And that's why we're here. That's why it's such important for us to be here to bring you these results.
Coming up next, we'll have the latest Hiller Sports update. Scenes from Elmwood School International Night, and Matt Clark on our HCAM Insider. A whole lot more ahead. Stay tuned.
HCAM programming is supported by our viewers. Thank you. And by Golden Pond Assisted Living, honoring resident choice, dignity, and independence. Our health and wellness focus keeps residents active. Golden Pond, state-of-the-art senior housing and healthcare services.
What would you do if someone gave you a television station? Would you run a camera? Host your own programs? Would you like to be a director or edit your own shows? Or maybe be a big-time producer? Or cover your local sports? Well, your station is ready for action. Start your media ventures with the workshop at HCAM. From setting lights and directing talent to editing, HCAM makes quality programs and teaches you to do the same. If you're interested in having fun and making a difference in the community, why not do it on TV? Join our crew and get your own piece of the action.
Thank you. Sharon Timlin Memorial stands as a true epitome of what the Angel Fund represents. A beautiful community event bringing together participants of all ages while being a shining beacon of hope for the countless among us looking to bring a cure for ALS.
The reason people come out to this race is to raise awareness for ALS and to strike out ALS. I, myself, do not run, but I show up every year because I believe strongly if some family has to go through what my family went through, if I can do anything I can to prevent that, I will. So please, come out, have a good time, and run.
Welcome back to HCAM News. Believe it or not, we are in the final 2 weeks of the high school spring sports season, and it's official. Every Hiller sports team has earned the playoff spot, but they are continuing to fight for home field advantage. Here's Tom Nappy with the latest Hiller sports.
On Tuesday, May 21st, all kinds of Hiller sports action took place, including Hiller softball versus Dedham. Before the game, they celebrated senior night. Bottom of the first, the Hillers struck first.
He's taking it all this season. And this is up the middle, that'll get through. Emily Whalen comes around to score. It's 1-0 Hillers. Katie Holly does it again, an RBI single.
Katie Holly makes it 1-0 Hopkinton. It remained that way until the top of the fifth.
Scirapa up the left side, that's a fair ball. Here comes Gonzalez to score, and she will. It's a 1-1 game. An RBI double for Scirapa. This is up the middle, gloved by the shortstop, throw to first, pulls Ansi off the bag, everybody's safe. Well, McIntyre looked to her left. You had Scarapa standing right next to her. She could have laid the tag on her. Big error there on McIntyre.
Three runs would score for Dedham to make it 3-1 at the time. That's how it remained until Jillian Cedia came up to the plate in the bottom of the sixth.
And she'll get a piece of this one to the wall, and see you later! Jillian Cedia does it again! Her fifth home run of the season, and she absolutely tattooed that ball. It is a 3-2 ball game.
Cedia crushes a home run to make it a 3-2 game, but Dedham would hang on for the win. The Hillers fell to 12-4 with the loss. Dedham improved to 12-5. Hillers baseball took on Dedham as well. Drew Rancatori at the plate in the bottom of the first with the Hillers trailing 2-0.
There's a fly ball deep right field. There goes the right fielder, and it is gone. A three-run bomb by Drew Rancatori. James Devonick went back to the fence, looked up, and it was gone. So that two-run lead by Dedham has been erased by a big fly.
Rancatori's homer made it a 3-2 Hillers lead. Dedham would plate a run the very next inning to tie things up at 3 apiece. And then later on, Dedham plated 3 more runs in the 4th and 3 more in the 5th to go ahead 9-3. Hillers trailing 9-3. Ben McKenzie came up to the plate with 2 on and 2 outs in the bottom of the 6th.
Ben got his eyes on. That's it. Out to left center field, and that ball is gone. Out of the yard, in the parking lot for a 3-run jack. Ben McKenzie. That's 3 to the board. It's 9-6. That was a no doubt about her. That's the way he hits him for his 4th home run of the year.
A three-run homer made it a 9-6 game, but the Hillers fall to Dedham 9-7. Hopkinton falls to 11-4, while Dedham clinched a piece of the TVL small title and improved to 13-3 overall. Hillers boys lacrosse celebrated their senior night and took on Dedham. Hopkinton struck early and often.
Possession. Dan Norton's done a tremendous job implementing his new strategy on both sides of the ball. And guess what? We have another goal. Dylan McBride striking for number 2 seconds. Good action to start this game here. And another goal. Steven Maffiore makes it 3-0. Net now. Out in front, McBride with a nice goal. Another assist for Luke McDonald, and Dylan McBride has the hat trick, his third goal of the game. 5-1 Hopkinton. That was just a nice shot. Swatted away and picked up quickly by Connors. That was Justin Kelly for Dedham hitting it with the back of his net. But then Connors was just there for the quick scoop. Now out in front, looking for a shot. And is that in? Yes, it is. Jacob Connors there with a goal. Well, Connors waiting in front. Wide open gap in front of him. Takes advantage, makes it 6-1 with 11.3 seconds left to go here in the first quarter.
It was a 6-1 Hillers lead after the first quarter. But right towards the end of the first quarter, Andrew Pelleco accomplished something incredible. With just over 11 seconds left, Pelleco wins yet another faceoff and then is swarmed by his teammates because that was his 1,000th faceoff win. The Hillers went on to take down Dedham by a final of 17-6. With the win, the playoff-bound Hillers improved to 11-5 overall, while Dedham fell to 5-12. Here's a look at the senior night festivities that took place after the game.
Corey Bannon greeting his family and handing his mother some flowers. There's Dan Sage. There's Zach Frank with his family. Mr. 1,000 plus face-off winner, Andrew Pelleco. Dylan McBride now. And last but certainly not least, we'll have Jack Sloan.
Hillers boys tennis also celebrated senior night before a sweep over Dedham. Hopkinton boys tennis is 13-0 on the season, just cruising through the regular season schedule and right into the postseason.
A whole lot of programs are coming up on the HCAM channels. Standing by to tell you about it is Matt Clark with our HCAM Insider.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to this week's edition of the HCAM Insider. I'm Matt Clark, and here's what's happening this week on HCAM. On Friday, May 24th at 5 p.m., storytelling duo Paul Slozik and Ron Whittle share their stories and poems on a new episode of Wake Up and Smell the Poetry. On Tuesday, May 28th at 6:30 p.m., the Hopkinton Select Board meeting will air live on HCAM TV. On Wednesday, May 29th at 7 p.m., attorney Arthur Bergeron is back at the Senior Center to discuss elder law on a brand new HCAM TV special. And also at 7 p.m., the Hopkinton High School Band, Chorus, and Orchestra perform in the final concert of the school year on a new HCAM Ed special. And at 8 p.m., the Hopkinton Planning Board meeting will air live on HCAM TV. On Thursday, May 30th at 7 p.m., the HHS Class of 2019 is celebrated for their accomplishments in the Senior Recognition Night, airing live on HCAM Ed. And on Friday, May 31st at 6 p.m., the Class of 2019 Commencement Ceremony will air live on HCAM Ed. And also on HCAM Ed, the Hillers Boys Lacrosse versus Norton game will air. If you want to know more about all of HCAM shows before they air, then head over to hcam.tv/connect, where you can sign up for our HCAM Insider newsletter. Or if you want to know more about what's happening in Hopkinton, you can sign up for our daily news updates. That's all for this week's Insider. I'm Matt Clark, and as always, thanks for watching. Back to you, Matt.
Thank you, Matt. That will just about do it for this edition of HCAM News. Don't forget to stay up to date with everything in Hopkinton by checking out our website at hcam.tv, as well as our Twitter and Facebook page. Be sure to head on over to our website for the latest happenings in our community and check out the Hopkinton Community Calendar to take a look at the upcoming events in town. If you have any Hopkinton-related videos, photos, or story ideas, I want to hear from you. Email me at news@hcam.tv. With your help, we can cover even more of our community. For everyone here at HCAM, I'm Matt Cardillo, and we'll leave you off now with current community listings and upcoming government meetings. As always, thank you for watching, take care, and we'll see you again next time.
On day one of town meeting, articles 1 through 9 passed unanimously, and the first debate of the night was over article 10. The fiscal 2020 operating budget raised some debate over the underwrite.
And given that the town has had many surprise expenses in the past year, and given that nobody is going to get a tax rebate as a result of any underwrite, I submit, Mr. Moderator, that the town should have a voice in whether this proposed underwrite is prudent. So therefore, I propose an amendment, or I propose that we vote separately on the underwrite.
Budget.
Mr. Moderator, I, as the maker of the motion, I would accept instead to simply delete the underwrite section, the non-binding underwrite part of the budget.
There was a motion to change language regarding the underwrite. The motion passed, and the $92 million plus town budget for fiscal year 2020 was then voted through.
$92.7 million.
23, the sidewalk master plan raised a whole lot of debate due to the proposal to construct a sidewalk along West Main Street.
Lanes, we have several things going on right there. We have a right-hand, we have two right-hand turn lanes. Then we have an exit that's supposed to merge into, and you're not supposed to make a left, but they always want to merge right in front of Cumbie's.
The article failed the required two-thirds majority with 124 voting for and 103 voting against the article. Day two of town meeting featured much debate. Article 25, purchase of a ladder truck, was first on the agenda. After some questions, the article passed by an overwhelming majority, 256 to 11. Article 27, town hall basement renovation, raise debate.
It's for file storage, it's for a kitchen, it's for an office. That isn't what the article says. It just says under the direction of the town manager.
The article would fail the two-third required majority with 175 voting for and 112 against. Article 26, 28, 29, and 30 all passed. Article 31 was the next big debate, mostly over the dog park at 66B Fruit Street. Despite a motion to separate the dog park from the article, all parts of the article would eventually pass. Article 32, car wash use, raised heavy debate. The article failed the two-third majority with 226 for and 117 against. After Article 33 passed unanimously, Article 34, self-storage facility, raised a whole lot of debate. Article 34 failed the required two-third majority. After Article 35 passed by an overwhelming majority, Article 36, Osma District, was heavily debated. The goal of the article was to remove the age restriction on the units to comply with state regulations. Article 37 keeps the age restriction in the Osma District in place while allowing the planning board to approve the creation of the required number of affordable housing units elsewhere in Hopkinton by the developer. The article passed unanimously. Article 38, which was essentially a language change, passed by an overwhelming majority to close out day two of the 2019 annual town meeting. On day three of the Hopkinton annual town meeting, there was a lot of debate about Article 42, which was a citizens' petition for a one-year growth restriction. The article would ultimately fail the two-third majority. Article 43 was to change the Board of Selectmen to Select Board. The article passed a standing vote with 258 for and 53 against. Article 46 attempted to make 76 Main Street a historic district to prevent demolition. The article passed a standing vote 287 to 70. Article 47 changed the maximum demolition delay from 6 months to 18 months. The article passed a clear majority. Article 51 also drew heavy debate. The article attempted to allow the selectmen and town manager to negotiate for a few different parcels of land to build a parking lot. Town meeting voted to allow the town to purchase 6 Walcott Street and a parcel of land at 25 and 35 Main Street, but declined 10 Walcott Street, 14 Main Street, and 0 Main Street.